A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 17th November, on the front page you have high turnout signals close Sri Lankan race, but this we'll see when the results come out. So, 80% polling has been recorded by an estimate, and minority Tamil Muslim regions also see over 70% vote. Then this is Delhi has the most unsafe tap water. So this is according to BIS standards. If you look at tap water in cities in India, you can see only Mumbai meets BIS standards. Water in Delhi is ranked the most unsafe in India. Samples failed in 19 out of 28 parameters, and samples from Mumbai met all parameters. So this is the study you can see. So this is a water tap ranking based on tap water quality released by BIS, Bureau of Indian Standards. Then this is the Congress to hold Bharat Bachao rally on November 20. So Congress has announced that it would hold a mega rally at Ramlila Maidan on November 30 as a culmination of its state level agitation against the policies of Narendra Modi led government at center. And this is severe air pollution in capital gone with the wind. So air quality index is still very poor, but Delhiites can breathe better now because severe category, pollution has gone in the sense that pollution has reduced because of wind movement. And this is why summons not served on Dow Chemicals. So Dow Chemicals is the company which is involved in Bhopal gas tragedy case, and a Bhopal court has asked Union Home Ministry to explain why it has repeatedly been unable to summon the Dow Chemical company to appear before it as in a case related to the Bhopal gas tragedy. So it's a US based firm and it has failed to appear before the court. So a show cause notice had been issued in May 2. Now it's the sixth time since 2014 court notices have gone unheeded. So show cause notice on the Undersecretary of Union Home Ministry has been issued. The Home Ministry is questioned why they are not serving notice to Dow Chemicals. On page 8 you have Kerala on track to eliminate TB by 2025. So it will now have to focus on strengthening diagnostic services. So this is the sixth joint monitoring mission of Union Government and the World Health Organization on revised National Tuberculosis Control Program, which has lauded Kerala for being right on track to achieve TB elimination by 2025. And this is market on a roll as Chile scales new heights. So analysts attribute price rise in AP to spurt in demand from overseas buyers. You should know Andhra Pradesh, it accounts for 65% of chili production in the country. On page 9, you have dam victims seek rehabilitation. So fishermen who have been hit by rise in water level of Narmada River are protesting, you can see. So these are farmers, potters and fishermen displaced by Sardar Sarovar dam project. They took out a rally in Bhopal in Madhya Pradesh. So this is the detail given here. And this is Navy MiG-29K crashes in Goa. Pilot ejects safely. On page 11, you have wasteland conversion threatens livelihoods, ecological balance. So environmentalists say the idea of wasteland is a political construct. So India wants to convert wasteland. Wasteland is mostly dense forest, scrub region, or not a forest, but scrub, dense scrub or glacial areas, or sands or marshlands. So these are called wastelands. So these wastelands, around 14,000 square kilometer of wasteland was converted into put into productive use between 2008-9 and 2015-16. And government targets to restore 26 million hectares of wasteland and degraded land by 2030. But then the environmentalists and social activists say that this is going to affect the livelihood of pastoralists, fishermen and nomadic farmers, who are often dependent on these traditional commons land as such. So these are commons, means they are open for everyone. So they depend on these for their livelihood. And commons, it is said, also act as a buffer against floods, droughts and pollution for a wider population. So this is a cause of concern, wastelands being put to productive use. So this is the wasteland atlas actually, which has been prepared in collaboration with National Remote Sensing Center and released recently by Land Resource Department. So it measures the extent of 23 different types of wastelands and the impact of reclamation efforts. And this is Orisha withdraws brochure on Gandhiji. So in the wake of widespread condemnation from political parties, civil society organizations and intellectuals, Odisha government admitted to having committed a mistake by describing Mahatma Gandhi's death as accidental in a brochure, and it withdrew it. On international page, you have the same news. This is regarding Sri Lankan elections, which is there on front page too. But you have to wait for the results. That is when we'll discuss this news. And this is Chinese soldiers helping cleaning up Hong Kong streets after protests. So protests in Hong Kong continue, and you can see the situation here is still has not escalated. But the Chinese government actually has shown restraint. And this is regarding Trump's impeachment proceedings and how Trump is interfering, and he asked about the investigations going on, which is alleged by an embassy staff. That is also not important. This is protests erupt in Iran over petrol price hike, one dead. So now protests are going on in Iran also. Demonstrations broke out after government announced increase in price by 50% for first 60 liters and 300% for anything above. So there were widespread protests. You can see one person was killed as such. On business page, you have governance key concern for public sector banks. So this is RBI Governor Shaktikant Das, who says that corporate governance remained the central concern of public sector banks, the lack of which was responsible for problems such as high bad loans, capital shortfalls and frauds. And this is Anil Ambani exits Reliance Communication Board. He says he, along with four others, have resigned. Reliance Communication actually recorded second quarter losses of 30,142 crore rupees, the second highest corporate India loss after Vodafone Idea, whose quarterly financials came out on Thursday, which is higher than this. So Reliance Communication has filed for insolvency and owes 47,000 crore to financial creditors. And this is Wildcraft to make rucksacks for army. So for the first time in the history of Indian Army, a third party firm will make rucksacks for Jawan. And these bags are made using high grade nylon. They'll be resistant to abrasion. They come with a lightweight alloy back framework so that they can comfortably stay on the back of soldiers even when they are mounting with armaments. So it will supply 1.8, Wildcraft will supply 1.8 lakh units of these 90 liter bags that can carry supplies for 30 days. Then on Sundays, you have FAQ coverage. So in this, there are important issues of the week covered. So first one is, what does the Place of Worship Act protect? So why was this act enacted in 1991? What was the cutoff date for this act? And why was the Ayodhya site kept as an exception to this act? So all this detail is provided here. And this is fixing a minimum wage. So why a minimum wage is necessary? How will the provisions of Code on Wages 2019 be implemented? It's detailed out here. And then minimum wage always has been one issue, because how should it be calculated and what should be the minimum wage turns out to be controversial. So this is important. And this is, what are the surveillance laws in India? So after the WhatsApp breach, which came to light, WhatsApp had revealed about it. This article says, what should be the way forward and why is the data protection law not in place in India? So what are the surveillance laws in India and how can data protection be implemented in the country? So that is detailed out here. This is also very important. On science and technology page, you have long-standing conundrum on the sun's atmosphere solved. So the study shows that if using high resolution and high cadence images, that sun, which is one of the most familiar celestial objects, it has an atmosphere. The core of the sun is nearly 15 million degrees Celsius, while its surface layer is known, which is known as the photosphere, is nearly 5,700 degrees Celsius. So, still further onwards of the atmosphere, which is of the sun, which is the corona. So the temperatures here, it is expected will be comparable to the surface, but the temperature of the corona is much higher. It starts increasing outside the photosphere, reaching a value of about 1 million degrees or more in the corona. So this is corona heating puzzle. So one would expect that as there are no extra sources of heat, when you move away from the hot object, the temperature steadily decreases. But with respect to the sun, this is not the case. So this implies that there should be a source heating the corona. So this puzzle of corona heating has been tackled by many theories. So this is a puzzle which needs to be answered, you can see. So it has been suspected that, you know, solar spicules that emanate from the interface of the corona and the photosphere, so they result in higher temperature. So this is a study which has deciphered how these spicules form and also show that they act as a conduit through which hot plasma is carried into the corona region. So this is the answer why corona temperature increases as we move away from the sun. And this is CTB, new diagnostic tool for detecting tuberculosis. So this is the device. It is battery operated and allows for quick identification of TB bacteria. Then this is weeding out black hole mimickers by looking at gravitational waves. So in September 2015, LIGO detectors in the US made history by directly detecting for the first time the merging of two black holes. So that was in 2015. And since then, LIGO, joined by other detectors across the world, has gone on to detect 11 events in which one is a merger of two neutron stars and remaining 10 of pairs of black holes. So apart from black holes, it is said universe contains many exotic objects such as gravity stars and boson stars. So all these have been studied and understood. Then on Sundays on the dispatches page, you have important international news covered. So the first news is fight for the future of Bolivia. So this is regarding Bolivia, the South American country. We have seen how Evo Morales, seeking a fourth presidential term when the election results came, Organization of American States talked of electoral malpractices and in its audit report, and Evo Morales resigned. But then there were widespread protests and he had to flee the nation. He has taken shelter in Mexico. He has taken asylum in Mexico, and now there are protests, fewer protests by grassroots organizations supporting Evo Morales. And this is shifting sands in the kingdom. So social and economic reforms in Saudi Arabia, it is said, are opening up new avenues for women. So now women can travel alone without any men with them, and such conditions which were there, they have been removed. Even women are allowed to drive cars now in Saudi Arabia. And this is releasing a terrorist for foreign hostages. So decision to free Anas Haqqani in exchange for two teachers has been widely criticized. So this is Afghan President Ashraf Ghani, who confirmed that the government has decided to free convicted terrorist Anas Haqqani. So the two teachers were abducted in 2016, and in lieu of him, they would be released. But this has been highly criticized. And this is China powers Africa's digital dreams. So in many African countries, the e-commerce ecosystem is beginning to take roots thanks to China. So this is also important from because India and China also fight for dominance in Africa. So this is important. So that is it. Then you have sports news. So these were the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com. Thank you.